Now available on Tata Sky channel number 526.
So clearly, political parties have supported this bill. And to talk to us more about the passage of the RERA bill, we have with us Rajya Sabha MP Rajiv Chandrashekhar joining us live here on the news and Magic Prakshna. Rajiv, thank you so much for taking time out to be with us. Tell us, what is your message to the home buyers who are watching us at this point in time?
Yeah, absolutely. I actually thank the Minister Venkaiah, Naidu and the government on behalf of the millions of home buyers that we met during our select committee consultations. I thank them for doing the right thing. I think this is a bill that puts the home buyer squarely and firmly on the table. He or she does not have to be a helpless victim anymore. They are strong, confident buyers and stakeholders of the real estate sector, rather than being victims of the might of real estate builders. So this has equalized the relationship as it should be between the buyer and the seller.
Rajiv, I wanted to ask you, what do you have to say about the escrow account being settled? You know, the limit at 70% of the cost of the project being put in an escrow account. Developers believe it'll take up prices even further. But I think it's a huge advantage for home buyers. As far as home buyers are concerned, what is your take on it?
No, I think the red herring that prices will go up because the cost of compliance is high is making a very, very weak argument. If the government believes that builders are getting together and driving up prices purely on the ground of having regulation and compliance thrust on the builders, then the government will ensure that there is more competition. The only real long-term guarantor of affordable quality housing is to ensure that there is more and more competition, more and more good builders that are getting into the sector, more and more investors that back these good investors, good builders, and that will revive consumer confidence in the building in the real estate industry. You must understand today that buyers are sitting on the sideline because they are suffering from a crisis of confidence in the real estate sector. There are many, many buyers who want to go and buy flats, buy homes, and they are just sitting on the sideline because they're concerned about what builders will do to them. So this is a very important catalyst to even revive the real estate sector, and builders must fully support this.
All right, but the big question here, now that this bill has been passed by the central government, is how long can we expect the other states to have their regulator ready?
Let's be practical, let's be clear. Governments in the states will respond basis the public pressure and media pressure. The ball is now squarely in the courts of the state governments and of course part of it in the central government. The consumer now knows that he can benefit if he makes the state government move towards these provisions in the law. And so it is really up to local populations, local media to start pressuring the state government to not dilly-dally, to move fast on reforms in the urban local bodies, move fast on all of these issues that require transparency and lack of opaqueness that are outside the bill. For example, planning approvals, things that impact the builders today. Those are things that public pressure will start making state governments respond.
All right, Rajiv, before we let you go, I just want to ask one more thing to you. Will states have the elbow room then to modify the regulator as per their set of rules and regulations, or will they have to comply to what they have on paper at this point in time?
No. There is considerable amount of leeway for states to do their own regulation. But this bill is a bill that is a national bill that has clearly established the legal rights for consumers and the legal obligation for builders. Now, in addition to this, if a state wants to improve on this, the state is quite, it's empowered to do so. The urban local bodies, in terms of enforcement, compliance, speed of permission and transparency, can do a lot more, and they must do a lot more. And if you heard what Mr. Venkaiah Naidu said in Parliament, the idea is for this bill and this legislation to be a catalyst in improving things all the way down to the urban local body. And this government of India plans to have model agreements, model building codes, model urban planning guidelines. So all of these things can go to the state and to the municipality, but they can then take that and either ignore it, or they can improve, use it and improve the standard of the real estate business and the real estate consumer in their city or state, as the case may be.
All right, Rajiv, we will leave it at that. Mr. Rajiv Chandrashekhar, thank you so much for taking time out to be with us here on the news on Magic Breaks Now.
You can watch live TV on our website, mpnow.in. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/magicbreaksnow. And don't forget to click the like button. You can also follow us on Twitter at Magic Breaks Now. To stay updated with all our programming, hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel by logging on to youtube.com/magicbreaksnow.